Where are you off to, guys?
My living room.
The living room?
St. John's Road, man. St. John's Road.
Yep, yep, yep. About to enter the living room right now. You already know what time it is.
What's going on, people? What's going on? Good evening. Hope you had a lovely weekend and all of them ting there. Straight into it, people. We're going to have a little bit of a rant, today. We're going to complain about the people, them, because that's what I do. Straight in, man. Bandwagons. Everybody loves to jump on bandwagons. To not be a hypocrite, I start with myself. I've jumped on many bandwagons in my life, and it didn't work out for me. The roads, started smoking weed. I was a criminal at a point, because I thought it was decent, you know what I mean? Bandwagons aren't always good. There's good bandwagons. I remember there was a point everyone was jumping on kind of like the kind of classy wave. I see this, everyone's being classy. I know a man that I know that I thought was a dirty, a criminal than me. He's classy now. So there's good bandwagons, this positive wave on social media. Everybody, no one don't want to upset each other. But bandwagons, man, I just want to speak about them. Because you see me, I'm a man, especially now. When I was younger, not so much. When you're younger, you kind of follow what's in. But when I was younger, to a certain extent, yeah, I don't like things that everybody likes, naturally. I don't know why, innit. It's just if a lot of people like something, I would force myself to dislike it. So like I said, I chatted to the man the other day, Dave. When Dave come out, didn't like him because everybody liked him. Slyly nodding my head to the music, but nah, I can't be with everyone. When drill started, nah, I can't. I gotta separate myself for a new one that people hate me for disliking, and I know nothing about it, but I don't really like it because everybody likes it, and there's people gonna hate me in the room already. Game of Thrones. Who watches Game of Thrones in here?
Do me a favor, please. Get out of here. Get out of here, man!
I hate it. I don't know why, but everybody likes it. I'll be honest, with Game of Thrones, the reason why I kind of hate that is I just thought it was on Netflix, like everything. So I kind of thought, you know what? I'm going to let people have their little Game of Thrones time. When I got a couple hours, I'm going to go find it. Went on Netflix, it's not there. And they're telling me they got to go on the internet to watch it for it to come out at 2 a.m. Got kids, hate it. Doesn't fit into my schedule of life, so I hate it. It's as simple as that. But bandwagons. I want to speak to you. Like I said, I jumped on the roads, man. And I want to speak to you about that. Because a lot of us kind of have this impression that, bruh, the roads chose me. I didn't choose the roads. The roads chose me. I had to walk this life. And don't get it twisted. Couple man is that. I know men whose mums might as well be gang members. I'll be honest. I know niggas' mums. I know guys with mums that's with it. That if they lost a fight, they'll send their youth back to the yard of the youth that punched them up and make them fight.
Punch him in his face! Don't back up! Stop falling! Back up! Fall me!
So yeah, a small percentage of us is the case, but a lot of us, bandwagon thing. Let's be real, man. When I was about 13, 14, so the bad boys were getting girls. Bad boys were getting money. Had the best trainers. And some of them even had cars. When I was like 15, I see a man come pass me in a Focus. What the fuck's going on?
I want to do it because it's fun. It's fun to do bad things, to drive into a car.
But did you know that you could perhaps kill somebody?
Yes, but I wanted to do horror stuff with my friend.
Bad boys got things. And like I said, at first, because everybody liked them, I didn't like them. But fuck these road dudes, man. I'm a footballer. Fuck with me. I got my shin pads in my bag and now I got new Total 90s. Like, what the fuck? Like that. You understand? But over time, even I started to like it. And naturally, I became a roadman. And it's not, this ain't even a story. It's kind of just, I'm just chatting to you lot. Because again, the youth them seem to think that like, we're some kind of, especially the road boys, I'm chatting to you. You think you're like some kind of special people that like are involved in something that no one could be a part of. Rude boy, I don't know about you, man. But the way I come on the road, I just went there, fam. I don't know if man had to go to the forest and kill a couple pagans to get in their thing. But me, I just stepped out. And I stood there, first couple weeks, long, I'll be honest. The bigger, the scarier guys, who the fuck is he? Rare tear, all of that. But after we got past all of that, I was gang. I was, and that's the case for a lot of you. And also, when it comes to leaving, a lot of people, like I see people on them, on them gang documentaries and their faces all covered up and their voices all deep. And they're like, yeah, I can't leave the gang. If I ever leave the gang, they'll kill my family. So I'm in this for life. I got crack up my bum right now and I got to sell it because this is the life. Shut the fuck up, man. Let's be really, really real gangster boys. When we're in front of auntie, mummy, dad, whoever, we're not gangsters no more, a lot of us.
Don't lie to me.
Like I said, you got certain man where their dad's just, oi dad, you got Rizla, you know them mad yards, them, you get me? You got, let me use you, you done with that crusher, mum? All of them mad ones. So you get me, there's them kind of man, I understand, they exist. But majority of us black boys, what? Rude boy, I've seen pagans and I'm with my mum and they're with their mum and our mums know each other. Oh, say hello to Red. Take you out, bro. Get me, stabbed my bridge in the other day, but fuck that. What's going on? You alright? Yeah, never seen you before. Not gangsters, what are you talking about, mum? We're on the way to church. What church do you go to? It's a madness. Bandwagons. Let's talk about the other side now, the gal them. I've never been a girl, but I've known a lot of them, so I think I can speak about them a little bit. And you're gonna kind of think, what the fuck's this guy talking about? But especially, this is kind of towards like the age I am now, innit? Gal relationships. Gal are on this relationship bandwagon thing. And let me tell you how I know. Cause a lot of gal that's been with me since I've been an adult, it's just been a bandwagon thing. It ain't even because they like me, it's just because they needed, it's cool to have a relationship in this current climate. So you can speak about it and take selfies and talk about data. You know, you get me? And man them-ish a little bit, but let's talk about the girls with their bandwagons. It's another one that I didn't happen as much when I was younger. It might just be because we're older and some of you lot's hair is nyama, but I don't know. Wigs. Bare gal got wigs. Gal with good hair got wigs. Gal with good hair have got wigs. That's like me, you can't see, I got a do-rag on. That's because my hairline is done out here, yeah? If my hairline was good, I'd never cover my hair with anything. I'd be in front of the camera like this. You understand? Look at me. And that's what I'm saying, the gal them got good hair. I would swap scalps with you if I could. And you're covering your good scalp. Why? Because Beyonce got it. Because Nicki Minaj, no, don't jump on a bandwagon. Another bandwagon that the gal them do. It's not over here. It's starting to come over here, but I hope it doesn't. I like the realness. I'm a real man. I like the real jelly. You know them way there. Certain gal, me like it. You understand? Surgery. I'm not going to go too in because I'm not. Don't really know a lot about it. But I watch them shows on MTV and all them thing there where like the implant in a gal's back is like slid down to the back of her thigh and shit.
Okay, this is my implant flipping backwards.
Cause she just wanted to, she didn't want to pay the real doctor in Miami. She went to fucking Doctor Brooklyn or something. Got some $150 implant something and now she dead. So it's like what, for bandwagons, people are dying. Like I said, I'm jumping on the road. What do you call it, Brazilian butt lift. Y'all are dead, y'all are dying. People are dying for bandwagons. I understand it's human nature. We're very, I don't know what to call it. We're communal creatures. I don't know if that's the right word, but we like to do what other people are doing. Everything we do, a lot of the times, because someone else done it. You get me? Even the languages we speak, we learn it from other people and rare tear. So we're always doing something that someone else is doing. But know what's for you and know what's not for you. I tell man straight, a lot of people are lippy, lick, shot, and gang, and rare tear, use a G. The roads was not for me. What? When I was with the man them, yes. Bad man. All the chilling on any corner with the man them. See, when I was by myself, it's cold out there, you know. It's cold when you're not with the gang, but you're in the gang and then you get caught by the other gang. It's long, because you can't even, the man them's not even there, bro. Like, it's long. So, obviously, I'm not saying, rah, if you're, no one should be on the roads. Like, don't get it twisted. I'm not saying if some of you should be on the road. No one should. But again, bandwagons, know what's for you, know what's not for you. Be original, man. Look at me, Lippy's living room. I was gang the other day. I was in my living room. Marks and Spencer, nah, Primark. Primark pyjama, £15 full set. I'm on my own flow. You understand? Certain man, the man there in the Balenciaga, Ugg boot, slipper, £7 million jean with all kinds of rips on it and all of that. Do your thing. If you like that, that's you, innit? I'm just saying, be original. Lippy's living room. You're done, no.